Savior of the world, we are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to bring before God our brother Walter, to give thanks for his life, and to commend him to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. We'll begin our service with the song, "Thank You for Being My Dad."
Thank you for showing me.
We remember before you today our brother Walter. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We come together today with heavy hearts to mourn the death of Walter. But as we say goodbye and lay him to rest, we also gather together to remember and celebrate the life that you all shared with him. A reading from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Walter was a beloved child of God. He was named and claimed by God all of his life. He was incredibly loved by God, and there was not a moment of his life that God did not walk alongside him, comforting him, leading him, restoring him, and providing for him abundantly. And because of God's abundant, overflowing provision, Walter was free to share with others. And sharing with those he loved is something that Walter knew well. Walter was many things to many people. He was a son and a brother. He was a cousin and an uncle. He was a husband, a father, and a grandfather. And he was a friend to many. It seems to know Walter is to know a friend. He was described to me as a person, a people person, who was always smiling. Everybody that he knew loved him, and he loved everyone he met. He was also a bit of a jokester. He liked to give people a hard time as an icebreaker or a way to make them feel comfortable. He just loved to make people laugh. He was a person who saw the positive side of things and would find humor in every situation. But he also had a quiet side. He was a very loving person with a big heart, and he took care of others. But he was also a little independent, or maybe it was that stubborn side of him coming out, but he didn't want people to fuss over him. As a husband, he was dependable. He was someone that you knew you could count on. He worked hard to take care of the family. But as a wife, you were amazing too. Caring for him in sickness and in health, that can be incredibly hard to do, and you did an amazing job of taking care of him. And I have no doubt that you appreciated everything you did for him. As a father, he was a good guide. He made sure that Whitney knew how to do things the right way. She also said that he was one of the strongest men she's ever known, and he was amazing. He was always there for her no matter what. Every time she called, he was there. He would drop everything to help her. Some of her favorite memories with her dad are when they would go hunting together. She remembers sitting up in the tree, not saying anything, being as quiet as can be, just waiting for her dad to shoot the bear. She also remembered a time when they went camping, and Walter made a whistle out of a tree branch, and she was just so amazed at how well the whistle actually worked. Whitney wanted me to share this poem. On angels' wings you were taken away, but in my heart you will always stay. I will hear your whisper in the tallest trees, feel your love in the gentle breeze. And when I find I miss you the most, inside our beautiful memories I will hold you close. What a beautiful tribute. Travis said that his favorite memories of his dad are when he would watch him go up in the bucket truck, and he thought that he was just the coolest guy ever. And his proudest moment was when his dad let him go up in the buckets, and he saw the trees down, and it made Travis feel as if his dad truly trusted him. Lyle spoke about how his relationship with his dad didn't develop until he was older, but he really appreciated the chance that he got to know his dad, cherishes the times they were able to spend together, especially while they were fishing. As a worker, Walter was a hard worker. And Walter knew all about hard work, having worked in the tree service industry with his brothers for much of his working career. Now I asked the family how that work came came to be, and no one really knows, but Travis said that he asked Walter, and Walter said he watched an old woman do it one day. So no one really knows if that's a true story, but it does make for a funny story. A reading from the Gospel according to John, chapter 14. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So today is a day of mourning. We can also find hope in the midst of the sadness, because death is not the end of the story. Jesus has gone to prepare a place for each of us, and he waits for us expectantly. We can rest in the hope and the promise that through the death and resurrection of Jesus, we are given eternal life and are welcomed into the loving arms of God. And we can cling to the peace that God gives us. Peace in knowing that Jesus promises that he will come and take each of us to himself. The Lord has prepared a place for Walter, a place where he is free from illness, a place where he is likely enjoying fishing all day long, a place where he is making everyone he meets laugh, a place where he is no doubt watching all of you and incredibly proud, a place where his love for all of you will go on forever. The Lord has prepared a place for Walter, and the Lord has offered him home. Thanks be to God for the life of Walter. Amen. We now hear the song, On the Wings of a Snow White Dove. Gate of death, we may pass with him to our joyful resurrection. God of mercy. Amen. us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all of our days. God of mercy. Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. God of mercy. Grant us grace to entrust Walter to your never-failing love, which sustains him in this life. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, and remember him according to the favor you bear for your people. God of mercy. Of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks because by his death, Jesus destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection has opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Gathered together, let us pray as our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Let us commend Walter to the mercy of God, our Maker and our Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Walter. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, into the glorious company of the saints in light. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the Father and in the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go forth in peace in the name of Christ. Now we hear the song Amazing Grace.
Thank you.